This colored pencil paint splatter drawing is such a fun way to use shading and blending of color to create realistic paint splatters that look really three-dimensional. For this tutorial, I'm using the most basic Crayola colored pencils in just the 12 pack of colors. This is something you probably already have at home, or if you're an art teacher, this is a really inexpensive material that you probably already have in your classroom. At the very end, I'll also show you quickly how to do the same technique using Prismacolors, which are a much more expensive material, on toned paper. If you love learning about art, hit that subscribe button. I upload art tutorials twice weekly in the summertime. To start, you're going to lightly, with a pencil, draw an organic shape. An organic shape is a shape found in nature that is random, with curved lines and edges, and is unpredictable. Using a pencil is smart in case you make a weird organic shape and you want to erase. So our shape today is representing a paint splatter or a like area of paint that fell on a tabletop or a surface. And so I'm gonna add a few little splatters off to the side. If you're interested in how to shade a water drop or a simple shape like this, check out my video above that will take you step by step with my shading techniques. Using your colored pencils, select about three colors that are in the same color family, and then start by outlining your organic shape with your dominant color. So I want my paint splatter to be a blue violet, and I could have started with any of the darker colors, but violet is the one I chose. So you're using your dominant color, and you want to use a darker color because your shading is going to be darkest on the outer edges. So right now, this is, you know, kindergarten stuff. You're just outlining like a coloring book with your dominant color. Now for the highlight. Very lightly, with your same color, you're going to draw on top of each expanded shape a rounded bubble shape. So we want this to look really rounded and three-dimensional, so we're gonna put a pretty big highlight on each of the areas that kind of spread out. Then you're gonna shade lightly with your colored pencil to connect your outline of the outer edges into where you drew your highlight. If you've never practiced a value scale before, click the link above and I will walk you through what a value is and how to do a value scale to practice. A value is the lightness or darkness of an object or a color. When blending colored pencils, you don't want to go too dark too fast. So you can see I'm staying in the lighter range of value because I'm going to be building up with my color and my value as I develop my paint splatter. The organic shape I drew is a little bit complicated, so it will take me some time to develop the rounded highlight and medium to light value for each one. So depending on what your shape looks like, take your time, and you want to do the same treatment of value on each and every part of your paint splatter. We are going to do a little bit of a different shading technique on the inside because there is an like kind of flat area in the central part of our organic shape. And so we're gonna leave some of that really light, and then some of that will be part of the darkest part of our paint splatter to make it really look three-dimensional. Shading lightly, I'm going to fill in the left side fairly dark, and I'm gonna leave that right side as a highlight. Now it's time to blend and introduce a second color into our paint splatter. I'm using the lightest blue, so you want your second color to be a lighter version of the color you're using. So if your paint splatter is green, you could use the light green or yellow. If your paint splatter is red, you could use orange. And if you have a bigger pack of colored pencils than I do, you have a wide range of choices. So notice I'm pressing down very lightly, and I am pressing harder on the darker edges, and I'm leaving the highlight pretty much white. You can see I'm filling it in a little bit with my lightest color. So you're gonna basically repeat the same steps you did with your first color. And I always like to press down lighter so I don't cover up my highlights or those really nice light values that I'm achieving. You can always go back and darken, but it is difficult to lighten up your colored pencils because although they will erase a little bit, it's not the same as just the delicate blending and shading using a delicate touch with your hand. Thank you. time to darken things up, go back with your dominant or dark color, and all the areas that you shaded, press down a little darker, not covering up your light value, but enhancing the darkest areas. So if you look at a paint splatter or a water spill on a table, there's these really beautiful dark shadows on the edges because there's this like bubble effect on top and then the shadows go around. So all I'm doing is playing with contrast and keeping my highlight as light as I can and my edges dark. Now I'm going to add a little bit of an unexpected color. So green is a cool color, so it does fit in the color family of my paint splatter. However, it's not blue or violet, so it gives a little bit more depth and dimension and interest to my color scheme. So already my vibrancy and the interest in this paint splatter is upped by mixing in colors that you wouldn't expect. Notice I'm using a light value and not pressing down too hard. It's not turning into a green paint splatter. The dominant color is still very much dominant. Now it's time to experiment with blending with white. Now with Crayola colored pencils, they're not as smooth and blendable as some of the more expensive brands, but using the white, it's not like you're gonna use it to create a white highlight. You still need to kind of avoid those areas, but it blends your colors together to create more harmony and kind of like a milky, creamy effect to your colors. Now it's time to play with shadows. And the darkest color of all is black, and I'm going to use that to play up the darkest areas of my paint splatters. So you can see right away, even though that violet is pretty dark, adding black to that area is making the contrast or the differences between your lights and darks just really stand out and pop. So black is a great color for adding a shadow. And in my next paint splatter, I'm gonna up your color theory knowledge by showing you a way to create a dark area without using black. A lot of painters and artists do avoid that color for blending because it is so dominant and it can gray out your colors, especially if you're using white as well. So for the basics, I'm using black for this one, and then I'll up your color theory knowledge, showing you how to mix complementary colors when we do the red paint splatter next. Look at how that just became more three-dimensional. So you're not just outlining. You don't want to go all the way around because that's going to flatten it out. You want to add your darkest shadow to the bottom of it. So imagine you're almost looking at your paint splatter directly overhead, but there's a slight shadow on the bottom of each portion. So watch how I'm kind of underlining just the bottom and not going all the way around. Now go back and blend with your dominant color into those dark areas of black that you've created. This will give your paint splatter more form and more of the effect that it's three-dimensional. Tired? Yes, that's normal. Blending with colored pencils requires a lot of overlapping, pressing down with your hand to really get vibrant colors. Okay, let's do this again using a different color scheme. I'm gonna speed things up drastically. Just like before, draw your organic shape and then pick your dominant color. I wanna do a red warm color scheme, and I love this red orange in my Crayola pack of colored pencils. So like you see me do before, outline, and then map out your highlight. Then with your dominant or base color, shade a medium to light value, leaving the highlights white. Your next step is to blend a lighter color, and for this, I actually chose two. I did orange and yellow. And the purpose of this is to give the lighter value into your color scheme and to mix things up with which colors you're using. Now it's time to create that dark complementary shadow. So complementary colors are opposites on the color wheel. You see I'm using green. So green and red are opposite colors, and when you mix those colors together, they create a dark neutral. So you can see it's almost like a brown is this neutral color that's giving my color scheme more dimension than if I use black by itself. Go back every time you add a new color with your base or dominant color to make sure that everything's blended naturally. Remember to use your white to create harmony in your color and leave that highlight pure white of your paper. I am using black to create the darkest, darkest, darkest areas just like I did in my blue water drop. Okay, let's slow things down a little bit. I want to create a cast shadow. I feel happy with the 3D effect of my paint splatter itself, but it doesn't really look like it's on a surface, which it's not flying through the air, it's resting on something. So I'm very lightly creating a cast shadow. Let me zoom in. So although I am using black, I'm not pressing down as hard as I did to create that like edge of my shadow. The cast shadow would be not your darkest value, but somewhere in the middle. I'm doing this really lightly, and I'm not doing a really long shadow. And then I'm gonna go back and add violet so it has a little bit more richness and depth in the color. Could stop here, but since I haven't used any of my greens yet, I want to go ahead and do a third and final paint splatter using my Crayola colored pencils, and then I can say that I truly used every color in the pack, well, except for brown, which I totally could have used. So you can see I'm doing the exact same technique that you've seen me do before, and I could fill my whole page with different colors and sizes and shapes of paint splatters. Look how 3D that green looks. Voila, paint splatters with the cheapest colored pencils ever. Okay, Prismacolors are my absolute favorite colored pencils. I had a student give me this pack of Prismacolors, and thank you so much, Hadley. This is the craziest, nicest gift I've ever gotten from a student. Prismacolors are expensive for a reason. Now, if you're doing toned paper like me, you need to actually use the white to create your highlight, and I can't believe how much easier these are blending. They're so rich and velvety, and I have so many more color options. Since I didn't have any pinks in my Crayola pack, I'm focusing on just like this really pretty pink violet paint splatter, and I do add some blues in there to really amp up my color scheme. The tone paper makes it look so three-dimensional because the white is really white, whereas the highlight on the white paper competes with the white background. But in this paint splatter, it's the whitest thing about the artwork. I always make things about food, but this looks like a dancing gummy bear stick figure. I don't really know what I'm thinking. And look at these beautiful, rich colors. I mean, it almost looks like oil pastels. Thank you so much for sticking around. And if you're interested in more drawing tutorials, check these out.